Well, hey guys, and welcome to this week's episode of The Artist Heart. It's great to be back here. I'm back in studio this week. It's a lot warmer, I have to say. Not much, but it is a tiny bit warmer. It's one of the things with having hard floors and not carpet floors is that you feel the cold a lot more. Anyway, I digress. Hope you guys are having a wonderful, wonderful week. I just wanted to literally just take 2 minutes just to share with you guys some of the stuff that we've been painting. Because I haven't done that in a while. I've done more tutorials on this kind of thing, which later in the show you're going to get to see how it was painted. But just to share a couple of things, bring them over. These are all framed and ready to go. And these are just some of the orders that we've been working on over the last, maybe the last 2 weeks or so. I'm just trying to place it so the light doesn't catch it. There we go. And this one's away to Ireland. This one's away down in England, I believe. And it's so exciting, and I am so thankful that I get to do these every single week. And again, when it's quiet, this is the golden lesson. When it's quiet, take time off. Still do your promoting, still do your work and everything, but take time off because it's so important just to chill out. And I've got a little cat that's coming in front of the screen here. He's coming to say hello. In fact, I'll bring him in now. Come here, Cooper. Come on. This is Cooper. And he stays with us, and as you can see, he's just completely not interested at all in what's going on. But he's a very cute cat, very affectionate, as you can see. And he's my buddy. He keeps me company when I'm painting and everything. So, do you want to go? Okay, get him on then. So those are two of the things that I've been working on over the last week or so. Something I've been working on for the last 4 months, and it's finally starting to come together a bit more, is the painting, of course, of the Notre Dame. I think when you guys saw it last, none of this stuff was done over here. The apartments weren't done, or the buildings weren't done. The guards and the armed forces weren't done. This painting set probably about 6 months, as I've said before, before the storming of the Bastille. So the guards at that time, believe it or not, actually took a lot of pleasure and joy in taking photos of themselves with dead bodies. So they would kill someone. It's almost, you know, sometimes people do this when they're hunting, that they'll take a photograph of themselves, with the animal, in its hands. I personally find it really gross. I don't like it. But, if you're going to hunt, I get that kind of thing. You go back to nature and everything else, but, taking photos of you with the dead animal, I just personally don't like. But that's me. It's my preference. But that was one of the more popular things that they would do, and that's why the guards are set here, because essentially the view of the painting, or the owner of the painting, is walking in between the guards. So these guys are eyeing you up. They're looking at you. And they're like, is this friend or foe, essentially. As you can see here, we've got some of the more, poor people at that time. These guys, some people think they're poor now. These guys, were literally scrimping and saving, and they didn't have homes. They were living out on the street. And if they got an apple a day, to them, that was a meal, So in comparison, we live very, very well. And then we've got the old priest over here as well. Going on his daily rounds of mass and communion. Here's an interesting fact for you. And I know some people disagree with this, but it's from the studies that I've done over the last 5 or 6 years. I'm not saying I'm right, but basically that is what I'm saying. during the time of the French Revolution, it's a very interesting time for the church, because the revolutionaries really didn't want anything. They didn't want any aristocracy, they didn't want any higher-ups or anything like that. And the Catholic Church actually really, really suffered during the French Revolution. Catholicism was basically taken out of France. There's wonderful documentaries that are more up-to-date and more recent. I've been studying it from books as well. And from some very well-known authors from the period and also from more recent times. I am a firm believer that it is important to know what you are talking about. It saves time as well. So that's a little bit of background in the history of that painting of that time. As I said, the Catholic Church really, really suffered, and basically Catholicism was driven out of France. They actually, believe it or not, renamed all of their months, and months weren't 30-day periods. It was, I think, if I remember correctly, 3 weeks or 4 weeks of 10-day periods, and it was essentially 10 months, if I remember correctly. My memory doesn't serve me that well for that documentation. But anyway, I'll stop waffling. This painting now, you're going to get the chance to see how it was painted if you are interested in the tutorials, if you are interested in learning how it was painted. Drop me a message. You can get in touch with me at johnmorrisartfromtheheart.com, or I always prefer the more personal way of doing it, which is just get in touch and drop me a message on Facebook. You know, so that's fine with me. You can also email us at johnafthmorris@hotmail.com, and I look out for them every day. So yeah, I don't think there's anything else I'm going to tell you guys, except it's 9 weeks now to the wedding. Cooper's just coming back in on my right-hand side. He's trying to get into the bedroom so he can go for a sleep. He's not allowed. Because he actually sleeps in the bed and not on the bed. And he always finds a way of getting in there. So anyway, so it's 9 weeks to the wedding. Busy, busy, busy. Lots going on. House hunting, flat hunting. And all sorts of other things that are happening. But I'm still busy. We're still busy with Art from the Heart and all the ventures and things that are going on there. Cushions, they're still selling. The throws, the duvets. What else have we got? Throws, duvets, pillowcases, pillows, prints, frame prints, metal prints, you name it. Basically, you know, we do it. And we do that so we can give so much of an option for everyone. So that's enough of me waffling on now. Enjoy the painting, and that's code for me that I'm going over time now. Enjoy the painting, guys, and I will see you at the end of the show with a final message. And enjoy, have fun.
I've been here before. Now here I am again, standing at the door. Would be only scratching the surface of who I've been known to be. Turn me around, pick me up, undo what I've become. Bring me back to the place of forgiveness and grace. I need you, I need your help. I can't do this myself.
Forgiveness and grace.
Enjoyed this week's episode of The Artist's Heart. We're getting near to the end of the second series, and it's really cool that this is building and growing every single week. I love doing these videos, and I hope you guys love them as well. As I say, tutorials are available. Excuse me, I had an itchy nose. Tutorials are available. You can message me, and we do those online, and I can give you more information about that as well. So until next time, guys, I don't have any closing messages. I think I got it through when we looked at the Storm of the Bastille. Be patient with one another, be loving, gracious, and faithful to one another would be the message of this week. Stay safe, stay warm. Summer's coming, spring's even closer, and by springtime I'll be off to get married. So I'm hoping we'll finish the Artist Heart series around, probably around April, just prior to me getting married. Stay safe, guys. Have a wonderful week. Take care and God bless.